What's going on, sports fans? Once again, it's K-Stu the GOAT for Vernon Speak Sports, mostly talking about Auburn football and the rest of the SEC. Want to give a shout out to my fearless and true gang, War Eagle. No, I'm coming on a little late tonight, but we got five unique possibilities for Auburn this year. Number one, I will not stop doing videos. That's one of the five. I will not stop doing videos. I absolutely love doing this. I talk about Auburn in some form or fashion every single day, so I might as well put this thing on YouTube and let you guys hear my thoughts. I'm either Googling Auburn. I'm trying to look up some of the latest news, a few sources that kind of helped me out. War Eagle. Number two, Auburn will have a top five defense. That's guaranteed. And I'm going to tell you why. Derrick Brown's return to the Auburn Tigers, Derrick Brown, defensive lineman for the Auburn Tigers, solidified a lot of possibilities for the Tigers. First of all, it gives, during the offseason, the fact that Kevin Steele doesn't have to really worry about that part of the defense. What he can start to do is concentrate on the more challenging part of this defense, and that is figuring out who's going to anchor the linebacker positions. It's my thought that KJ Britt and Owen Papo will probably have to help out immediately as a true freshman. Owen Papo probably will not redshirt. He probably will actually be playing on that Auburn defense. And then the secondary, with so much experience and so much more talent than it has had in recent years across the board. Now, it was a situation where, let's say, you will have a guy like Carlton Davis, but then everybody else is kind of mediocre or subpar. So they won't throw it to Carlton Davis' side, but they'll pick apart everybody else. But you don't have that situation. You have, as a combined whole, a much more talented skill play in the defensive secondary. So I think Auburn, with all of that in mind, will have a top five defense. And going into number four is another reason. I mean, going into number three is another reason why Auburn will have a top five defense, because their offense will dramatically improve. And that's not really saying much, because for the most part, the offense was just anemic, especially in the high consequence SEC games. You're talking about against Georgia. Georgia was actually a pretty good football team, and you're definitely not going to beat a team like Georgia with only 228 yards and 17 minutes of time of possession. It's just not going to happen. But with Gus Malzahn calling the plays, and it is just about guaranteed, he's going to have a real deal dual threat quarterback, unlike Jarrett Stidham. Jarrett Stidham had no intent in running the ball. So it's almost like the run pass option was non-existent, because when Jarrett Stidham does a fake to the running back, I mean, the linebackers know that for the most part, Jarrett Stidham is not running the ball. But with the quarterbacks you have now out of Bo Nix, Malik Willis, I actually feel that, you know, with Coach Gus Malzahn's coaching, I think Malik Willis actually has a shot to be the quarterback to start the first game, unlike my thoughts from previous videos. So Auburn's offense will definitely dramatically improve. Okay, so number four, I think you guys need to get your popcorn ready for this one, because the stretch between September 21st and October 28th will be the meat of the season. It will be emotionally draining. It's going to be dramatic. You know, this is during the stretch where you have Florida, Texas A&M, LSU, Mississippi State. The bulk of the SEC games are going to be played during this time. Now, I'm not too sure, but I know one of these games, I just pencil it, one of these games are going to be a 12 o'clock game. A couple of them are going to be CBS games. The only thing is, Auburn has to go to Florida. I really am not trying to sit through a Gary Danielson call game against Florida. That's going to be a high anxiety game. I just really don't feel like dealing with listening to Gary Danielson for 3 hours calling the plays before the ball is even snapped. All right. So, you know, you can rest assured this is going to be a very dramatic period of the season. And I don't think with that stretch, I think this is where one of Auburn's losses is going to come from. My pick, if I was just to pick just offhand, I would say Florida. Florida is going to be a very tough game for Auburn. Down in Florida, first time playing there in a long time, Florida's kind of sort of on the upswing. That's going to be a very, very interesting matchup that Auburn, that could be a trap game for the Auburn Tigers. And number five, last but not least, I feel like with everything that Gus has going on, all the guys he has coming back, he has a chance to actually, a very unique opportunity to finally get off the hot seat. He's pretty much been off and on the hot seat pretty much since he's been there. I'm actually tired of him being on the hot seat because it's a real distraction. You know, it's a real distraction when you're always playing for your job. You don't have any, you know, real solid support from your fan base or legitimately from the administration. And I'm hoping that this will be the end of the hot seat Gus Malzahn. He actually executes, wins those games that he should win, and goes ahead and let's move on with this recruiting and the Gus Malzahn era, which has the opportunity to be one of the better eras in Auburn football history. Once again, it's K-Stew the GOAT for Vernon Speaks Sports, mostly talking about Auburn football and the rest of the SEC. Want to give a shout out to my fearless and true gang. We're growing, guys, so let's keep this thing going. Like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you on the next video.